This is the official Waukee Community School District podcast, Talk the Wauk, presented by Unity Point Health Des Moines. Welcome to another edition of the Talk the Wauk podcast, the official podcast of the Waukee Community School District, presented by Unity Point Health Des Moines. My name is A.G. Ellingson, Communications Coordinator for the district, and we're excited to be coming to you today from Maple Grove Elementary with Principal Kim Tierney. Principal Tierney, thanks for coming on. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm thrilled to be a guest on this podcast.
I should have timed this better because as a Cardinals fan, talking to a Cubs fan today is not the best. So tip of the hat to the Cubs win last night.
That's right. It's a good deal. We're really proud of our Cubbies. They needed to redeem themselves after the night before. So
we got the Cubs fan. We'll leave that there. No more questions about the Cubs.
That's right.
So let's get to know you a little better. Why are you here? Why are you the principal at Maple Grove?
Absolutely. Well, I had the privilege in 2004 to start my career within the Waukee Community School District. And at that time, it was, you know, much smaller than it is now. But immediately you sense that pride in the type of district that we are. You know, cutting edge professionals that continue to challenge one another, collegiality beyond belief. Those things existed then, as well as the support from the community, and they still exist today. And so in 2004, I taught here for 4 years. I ended up leaving Waukee to take my first principalship in a small rural community in northeast Iowa, Denver Community School District. And while I loved every second of that opportunity, I was thrilled with the chance to be able to come back to the Waukee Community School District when Maple Grove's position opened in 2014, and I've been here since, starting my eighth year.
You've probably seen a little bit of every kind of year between now and then. You've had about a month and a half to yes. digest and reflect yes. on last school. What's popped out the most to you? What sticks out as a moment you'll remember from last year?
Absolutely. Well, it seems like every year has a theme of some sort. I've always been able to kind of capitalize at the end of the year, May or June, and look back and feel like there's some sort of theme to that school year. But I'll tell you what, in this past year, I was so impressed with so many things. The dedication and perseverance, as well as the positivity of our entire staff, and that'd be across our district, but specifically at Maple Grove. The resiliency of our students, both those that were online learners and those that were learning in person, and then also the support from our families. I'm so prideful of the community that we live in and the amount of support that we have from our families and community members. It's really second to none. And then also just, you know, I'm so proud of the communication from the top down. Our senior leadership team is encompassed of the best educators in the state. And I'm so proud to work under them, as well as our school board that is absolutely wonderful at listening to the community and listening to our senior leadership team in order to make decisions. When I think about what I learned, however, I think about that learning and connection is still possible regardless of the circumstances that we endure. And that was the case this last year. I was able to see teachers making connection through video, through phone calls, whatever they had to do to support families when the time arose. That connection piece is and I feel always will be the cornerstone of what we do in Waukee Community Schools. And I believe that sets us apart in a lot of ways, but we continue to make that kind of our cornerstone. And regardless of the situation in this past year, it definitely was a wonderful experience. The message, you know, that I ended up giving to staff as they left, though, in such a tumultuous year was to kind of step away and regroup. They needed that opportunity to really pull away from school. And I encouraged them in a recent memo that I gave them to not come back in until August. We take the opportunity to educate the kids we serve very seriously. We know that they have one opportunity, 6 years, to come through this elementary system, and we want to give them the best opportunity possible. And our teachers need to be prepared mentally, emotionally, and socially for that, physically as well. So giving them that opportunity to really step away was important this year.
Was there a moment this past school year where you kind of were just hit you of like of all of the things that were happening and you're just were where yeah. whether it was a pride moment, a positive moment, just of like we're doing mm-hmm. this or mm-hmm. something even the bigger like we can do mm-hmm. anything. Was right. there a moment like that?
Yeah, just you saying that nearly brings me to tears because I'm so proud of our staff and our families and students. There were many times where I'd be on a call via Google and I'd see all of our staff's faces, you know, through the screen and just feel this immense amount of pride for the work that they did and were doing and doing it so positively. I didn't hear complaints last year about the work that we were doing to support our kids or the extra effort that they had to make or the time that they took away from their family to give to our students in order to prepare, you know, the best quality education. I think back and I look back number of times at the times where I just felt that immense amount of pride.
It's got to be kind of a cool spot in your position when you hear those conversations. I mean, when I was in buildings and, you know, it was more than it is what it is. We're doing it. Mm-hmm. And we're just but like whether you were teaching online, like online teachers were proud of being an online teacher. In person was like, I don't know who's going to be here today, but yes. I'm proud to be here. That's kind of just be a cool feeling and like walking through the halls here.
Absolutely. I saw that time and time again. And that's Wauk-ee. You know, whatever we're going to do, we're going to do it the absolute best. And we're going to try to trailblaze and shape the mold for others that follow. And hopefully we never have to deal with that sort of pandemic again. But I feel like looking at the way that our school district handled that situation from the school board to the senior leadership team, to our staff at any level, we did a really great job and our kids were in school and they were engaged and they were learning, as I said, and that can't be said across the country. You know, several students never stepped foot into their school building and we offered opportunities both online and in person.
It was also kind of cool just about the kid aspect of it because, I mean, they loved it. I mean, you wouldn't know there was a pandemic going on by all the things that these kids were doing. Was that fun to just to see, especially in your building, elementary kids where energy is kind of what they do best?
Absolutely. It was an opportunity to step outside the mold. Wauk-ee Community School District isn't a district where, you know, we copy the lesson plan, we put it in the file, and we use it every year. We're obviously always recreating, you know, what students need each year. But this year was especially different in that basically everything that we've ever known had to be thrown out the window and we got the opportunity to recreate. So it was fun. It was energizing, but it was really cool to see the kids respond to that too and learning and doing things in different ways.
This is the Talk the Wauk podcast presented by Unity Point Health Des Moines with our featured guest, Kim Tierney, principal of Maple Grove Elementary. So now here we are, middle of July, summer months. School obviously looks different than it will at this time in 2 months. What's going on at the school? What are you working on? What's happening here?
This is the famous question. What do principals do during the summer? Do you really work during the summer? And the answer is a hard yes,
100%,
actually, AJ.
Yeah.
You know, we've got a checklist actually that our assistant principal, our instructional coach and secretary kind of put together, and it has surprisingly over 150 items combined. So it's a slower pace, I'll give you that, but there's a lot of planning and preparation that goes into the school year. School years don't automatically just happen when the students show up. There's so much behind the scenes that occurs that we're really proud of to set ourselves up for success. And so that includes scheduling and, you know, human resources. We're continuing to hire, you know, thinking about the growth that we experience. We have associates that we hire, long-term subs that we organize, as well as budget cleanup and organizing. But probably the biggest thing is our school improvement planning. So just continuing to think about and reflecting on the goals that are data-driven at the elementary level that we create at the end of the year. And then thinking about holistically, what does that professional growth look like based on those goals? From our staff to our students, everybody in between contributing kind of towards those cascading goals that we create at our building. That's probably the most important. And of course, you have scheduling and the emails and communication to staff. I could go on and on, AJ. We're busy here. But, you know, honestly, in all seriousness, the opportunity to refresh is real for elementary school principals, too.
And important. And very important.
It is so important.
And also, there's when your kids come back, there's a new look playground. The soft surface has been installed. So that's exciting.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. Yes. Another reason to just be really proud to be in the Wauk-ee Community School District. The support we get with our facilities, you know, we're constantly updating and refreshing and making sure that it's the absolute best state-of-the-art facility for our students to learn in. And that's incredibly important, as well as just the custodial and operations staff and their hard work during the summer, enabling us to come back and really focus on learning because they've taken care of everything else.
So with that comes, I'm sure when you're working through this summer, the excitement starts to build, mm-hmm. maybe after the 4th of mm-hmm. July and as we turn to August. Oh, yeah. What are you most excited about next year?
Yeah. Well, I think, you know, with the new year comes less structure around some of the mitigation. We'll still have some small mitigation in place, but it'll definitely be different compared to what we've had previously. And it'll be more focused around what we've had in the past around creativity and autonomy that buildings are given and teachers are given, and more focused around our continuous growth with our culture climate goal, our academic goals, as well as the social emotional needs of students. Gives us an opportunity to really, after this past year, really think about what's most important and how we kind of filter that back into our school year. So an opportunity of rebuilding and rebranding some of the initiatives that we thought were the cornerstone of the work that we're doing. We realized last year some of those things maybe could take a little bit of a back seat, and we can focus more on the social, emotional, academic needs of our students without such an emphasis on some of those other initiatives. So we're excited to just kind of recreate. It's kind of a blank slate this year, and we've got some exciting things coming down the pipeline that we're working on with some leadership teams in our school this summer that started this past school year, and we've got a lot of exciting things happening.
How big of a deal do you think that the second high school will be, and as it trickles down to your school? I know, you know, obviously, the 10-12, there's way more opportunity coming their way. But how do you see that changing the way it's talked about or discussed here?
Well, I think you hit it on the head. I think number one is opportunity. I think, once again, Wauk Community School District does it right by dividing a large district into two high schools. That, you know, as a parent, as an administrator and advocate for kids, that gives them that much more opportunity. But I've been doing a little bit of reading this summer around the science of the heart and the role of the heart in the personal coherence of a student. And I think it's incredible because I feel like the addition of Northwest adds to our students' identities and their coherence. And even though Maple Grove students will be going to Wauk High School, that creates a connection and a friendly rivalry that allows these students to connect at a stronger level. You know, I have a feeling that there's going to be a pretty good rivalry between the two schools. And given that, I just am in awe of the excitement that will endure alongside that for our students that attend Maple Grove and the other Southside feeder schools to be able to have that, because their connections with each other will grow stronger. And at the elementary level, we're trying to support that too. There's a lot of excitement going on right now about Northwest High School, but there's a lot of excitement for Wauk High School as well. And so we're going to try to instill that as much as possible, get that school spirit and build the connections between the high school and the elementary level as much as possible.
I didn't put this on our list of topics today. Here's one more question. What your message to Maple Grove, the Maple Grove community about just what happens here and what's going to happen here in 21-22 is what's your overwhelming message that you want to display?
Yeah, I think connection. I think the number one thing that we're really going to focus on this next year is connection. We want every student to feel as though they're such a strong part of our elementary building and that their attendance here matters, and that without them being here, we're not going to be able to operate at the same level if they're not here. So I think that's the most important thing. We realize that every child that comes through our doors has a gift to share of some sort. And our goal is to be able to find that gift and that opportunity that they bring to us and let them shine in that way. And we're really excited to do that through the more, creative and autonomous ways that we've done in the past. So it's going to be an exciting school year.
I feel like you guys are already well on the way. I mean, some of the stories that we've done here, I mean, you've got teachers who are just so passionate about that work.
Yep.
It's one more touch on this again. Yes. It's got to be cool just to kind of see. I mean, that's not a message that's coming from the top down. Mm-hmm. That's like a message that we're all behind. We all want to be involved mm-hmm. in and chip in however we possibly can.
Absolutely. And that's simply the work of Wauk Community School District. We believe that we can make a difference. Our staff are the utmost professionals, and they hold each other accountable, and our community holds us accountable for that as well. But you have to have a high level of passion and perseverance to work in the Wauk Community School District, or in any school, for that matter, right now in education, because it's really hard work. and our teachers put forth an amount of effort that's second to none. And there isn't a day that goes by that I'm not proud of them for the amount of work that they do. But I can tell you that each of them are incredibly passionate. Each of the teachers here at Maple Grove are teachers that I'd want my own children to have as classroom teachers. They're just so passionate, and it's evident in the work that they do day in and day out.
Okay, kid question of the week. Obviously, there's no kids around in your classrooms here, so I came up with this one. What is your favorite summertime activity?
Oh, by far, boating with my family. So we have a pontoon now, and we love to go boating as a family and just dip in the water and just enjoy each other's company as much as possible.
For a Cubs fan, you did a great job on this podcast. We appreciate you being here.
We'll beat the Cards any day.
Next time, we're coming after the Cardinals beat the Cubs. I'm not doing this again. Thank you, Principal Tierney. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
And we can't wait to see your kids back in Maple Grove soon. All right, exciting things planned as we get ready for next school year. Our next guest on Talk the Walk, presented by Unity Point Health Des Moines, will be Dr. Feruz Bashar Rantisi, the principal of Waukee Northwest High School. Her doors will open in 1 month. We will see you next time on Talk the Walk. Thanks for listening to Talk the Walk, the official podcast of the Waukee Community School District, presented by Unity Point Health Des Moines.